Many people visit the rock wall and high ropes course of adventure seminars and feel their pulse quicken and palms start to sweat from fear.
Hey, new staff member!
Are you ready to get trained?
Many of their concerns are unfounded due to a multitude of backup systems designed to keep all participants safe. However, one of the main attractions of the high adventure activities, such as the high ropes course, is that feeling of perceived risk.
In order to stay safe up in the air, Adventure Seminars utilizes a static belay system consisting of two nylon ropes connected to the harness with a steel carabiner and to the ropes course wires with two steel lobster claws.
In this video, we are going to discuss ways that Adventure Seminars prevents this from ending in a hospital visit. One action that Adventure Seminars discourages altogether is swinging on ropes in order to avoid the potential hazard of getting caught or falling. We also ask that no participants use our facilities of any kind, such as the slack line, rock wall, bouldering wall, or ropes course, without the supervision of a staff member. Transfer some risk responsibility to our participants. All climbers must sign an informed consent and release form which lays out the risks involved in adventure seminars and saves us from being sued from those potential hazards. Another transfer technique is the use of ground buddies, which spreads the responsibility of supervising a participant on the ropes course to an extra participant on the ground in addition to our staff. To reduce severity of an injury from a minor fall at our facilities, we use padding beneath the rock walls and the slack line. One of our frequency reduction techniques to risk management is the head-to-toe check on every participant before they start to climb. We'll discuss this technique more in depth soon. And of course, we always wear helmets on the high ropes course. Safety is our number one priority at Adventure Seminars, so we work hard to make sure no obvious risks are retained. To get a climber ready to go, first ask them to remove all objects from their pockets. Next, help them to properly secure their harness. It should sit high on the waist and be tight but not uncomfortable. Finally, ensure that all buckles are double backed, the tail end back through the buckle so that it cannot come loose while on the course. The head-to-toe check literally starts at the head and moves down to the toes to make sure there are no hazards on the climber's person. Does the participant have their hair tied up, earrings out, helmet secure, coat off, shirt tucked into the harness, harness tight and in position, harness double-backed, pockets emptied, dangling wristbands taken off, closed-toed shoes properly secured? If so, they're good to go. We always go over safety procedures before letting participants use the facilities. Our lobster claws are of vital importance to the safety of the high ropes course. You must explain that the lobster claws open by pushing on the front and back simultaneously, and that they must go completely on the rope wire. When placing the second claw on the wire, make sure the opening is on the opposite side of the first one. The most important thing to keep in mind when transferring claws from one wire to another is that you never remove both at the same time. Ground buddies are important for several reasons. They involve more participants in the activity, but also increase safety. Ground buddies help their air buddy to complete lobster claw transfers, but also keep an eye out for any other hazards that may arise. It definitely helps an air buddy who is afraid of heights and likely to forget a step. Ground buddies are the authority in transferring claws. Let's watch a great example transfer.
Permission to transfer hook one.
Permission granted.
Check hook one.
Check.
Permission to transfer hook two. Check hook two.
Check.
As staff members, we need to be watchful for a variety of potential issues in the ropes course, including non-opposite claw openings.
Permission to transfer hook one.
Ground buddies who are not paying attention to the air buddy.
Catherine.
I'm Oh, yeah, permission granted.
Participants who need help on an element.
I'll come get you.
And especially when somebody unhooks himself completely from the ropes course.
Stop!
There are industry standards that one must follow to be an accredited high ropes course. One of the better known agencies is the Association for Challenge Course Technology. One such standard is inspections.
Equipment is professionally inspected every year.
Every piece of equipment generally holds at least 5,000 pounds of force.
One participant in 26,000 falls victim to a major accident.
One participant in 7,143 falls victim to an injury of any class, major, minor, or medical incident.
At Adventure Seminars, we know that with our extensive training, falls like this are perfectly safe.